So we started with mesomeric effect, right? Yes,
Yes, sir.
guys. Mesomeric effect. So we wrote the last line. I think that is all resonance effect are not mesomeric effect, but all mesomeric effect are resonance effect. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Okay. So there are two types of mesomeric effect, positive mesomeric effect and negative mesomeric effect. Did I, we gave some example, right? So let us write, first of all, regarding the positive mesomeric effect. पॉजिटिव मेसोमेरिक इफेक्ट. अच्छा, एक चीज आप लोगों से ये पूछनी थी, हाइड्रोजन आप लोग के टर्म वन में था या टर्म टू में था स्कूल में आपके?
सर टर्म टू.
टर्म टू. अच्छा ठीक है. ओके, पॉजिटिव मेसोमेरिक इफेक्ट, प्लीज राइट द डेफिनेशन. सो वी हैव सीन दैट व्हेन वी व्हाट इज हैपनिंग when we have electron that is getting away from a functional group, right, or a substituent. Electron, if it gets away from a functional group or substituent, then it is known as what? Positive mesomeric effect, right? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes. So you can write electron density moving away. Electron density moving away from functional group or substituent. Okay, functional group or substituent. First example, please write the first example. If you have a benzene ring and NH2. Okay, you have benzene ring and NH2. What will happen? See, if you have this term now, if you have a double bond, then you have a single bond, then a lone pair, then what will happen? The resonance will happen like this. This is not double bond. NH2, and this will have a positive charge because electron has left from nitrogen. Electron has left from nitrogen. This pi bond will break and you will get a negative charge here. Okay, you will get a negative charge here. Now what will happen? A double bond B, single bond C, and C has a negative charge. So this will go here. Sorry. From high electron density to low electron density, that is why this will be moving. Okay, that means the negative charge is what you will have always. Electron transfer will start from positive in positive mesomeric effect, either from lone pair electron or from negative charge. Okay, you will have the tail of the arrow at negative charge or lone pair. Okay, then you will have a double bond NH2. This will be here and this will be moving in this side. The negative charge here. This bond is as it is. Then again, NH2 is here. And this bond will move here. This bond will move in this atom. So here you will get a double bond. Here it is a double bond already. Here you will get a. And see, this nitrogen is having a positive charge all around, okay? And now what will happen? This negative charge will go here. This double bond will go here and it will again get to nitrogen as a lone pair electron. So NH2, that will be neutral because positive and negative charge, they will neutralize each other. And here you will get a double bond, here double bond, and here a double bond. Okay. Now, these are the resonating structures. If I will make the resonance hybrid for aniline, right? You remember this is aniline, yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now what is there? NH2 is there. Right, NH2 is there. Achha, wait a second. Sorry, I should not make these double bonds because it is all are. Correct? Yes? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, as you can see, what is happening here, there is negative charge. Okay, at this point, let us see at which point we have negative charges. At this point, we have negative charge. This point, we have negative charge. And this point, we have negative charge, right? So we have seen that we have negative charge in the ortho. So delta negative here in the para, delta negative here, and then you have the meta, sorry, then again ortho, right, delta negative here. So as we can see, what is the, if there is some electron donating group present, then at the ortho and the para position, electron density increases, yes or no? Electron density is increasing, na? If we have, if plus M group is attached on benzene, then electron density increases in ortho and para positions. Yes or no? Can you see that?
Yes, sir.
Very good. Let me know if you're done writing this. Let me know if you're done writing this, guys.
Done, sir.
Done, okay. So first of all, and this is one of the example, but how will you identify whether something has, how will you identify whether something has a, is a positive mesomeric effect or a negative mesomeric effect? For that, we will then learn about negative mesomeric effect. Okay. Negative mesomeric effect. Okay. Negative mesomeric effect. Now, what happens in electron negative mesomeric effect? Electron
density
moving
towards functional group.
Yeah, very good. Moving towards the functional group or substituent. Okay. Functional group or towards the substituent. So for example, if you have this is a benzene ring, okay, and you will have a nitrogen, a double bond oxygen and a single bond oxygen, okay. Since nitrogen is making how many bonds? It is making 4 bonds. That is why it will not have any. So there will be a positive charge here and there will be a negative charge here, okay. Just please remember, that is why this is completely neutral. Positive and negative charge, they will neutralize each other. Positive and negative charges will be there. Now, the benzene has these parts. Now, what will happen here? How will we start the bond? See, this electron pair will move towards oxygen first. Okay, more electronegative atom, towards the more electronegative atom. Now, as soon as it is moving towards the more electronegative atom, what will happen? This nitrogen will ask for more number of bonds, then this pi bond will take care of the valency of nitrogen and hence it will be bonding with nitrogen. Now, let me just copy this now. I think that will help me. For the next one. So here, what do we have? Now, when we have broken this bond, so this will be a single bond. Now, this pi bond has got here. So this is now double bond. And this is still what? Positive. This is negative. And since oxygen has only one bond, that is why it is be negative. Okay. Now, when this is all negative, now also, say this carbon atom and this carbon atom. So this carbon atom initially had 3 bonds. It initially had 4 bonds. Here also, it is having 4 bonds. But this carbon atom initially, you can see there are 3 bonds and one bond is broken. That is why it will get a positive charge here. Yes or no? Can you see the positive charge? Right, positive charge. Now what will happen? A double bond, B single bond. C and a positive charge. So this electron will move this side. Now, if the electron will be moving this side, then we can write the next resonating structure something like this. There's a double bond here, right? There is a positive charge here, and there is a double bond here, and this has positive charge, negative charge, and negative charge here, okay? Now, in the next resonating structure, what we'll do? Now, what will happen? This negative, this pi bond will move this side, okay? This pi bond will move this side, so we'll get a double bond here, we will get a single bond here and a positive charge here. Okay. This is double bond only. This is double bond only. Okay. Now what will happen? The next we will have this double bond will be shifting this side. Okay. This double bond will be shifting this side. This negative charge here. This is negative charge here. This negative charge will be shifting this side. This negative charge will be shifting this side. Then you will get to the original structure. That is, we'll have a double bond here. This will have a negative charge. This will have a positive charge, obviously, because there are four bonds. And then this double bond will be broken. You will get a double bond here, a double bond here, a double bond here as it is. And this is again the back to the same structure. For resonance hybrid, we can write it like this. A double bond, no. Then you have here NO2. This is also partial double bond character. But here you have delta positive. Delta positive and delta positive, right? So you will write presence of minus M group on benzene decreases the presence of minus M group on benzene decreases the electron density. At ortho and meta. It's ortho and para, no? Para position. Okay, regarding the resonating structures, now you can only get command. You can only have command if you will practice this, okay, at home. आप लोग अभी मेरा देख के बस लिख दे रहे हैं तो उससे नहीं कुछ होगा प्लीज आई हैव ड्रॉन फॉर NO2 एंड फॉर NH2 ना देन प्लीज रीड्रॉ दिस ओके प्लीज ट्राई टू रीड्रॉ दिस ऑन योर ओन एट योर होम खालिद यू हैड योर एग्जाम ना
Yes, sir. Our exam is done.
How was it? Kaisa gaya?
Yeah, it was good.
It was good. What about you, Salman?
It was easier than expected for me.
Easier? Achha, easier than expected. I mean, is this the same? Is everyone saying the same thing in your class? That is, it was easy?
No, sir.
So I mean if you found it easy then you have worked hard okay please don't say that nothing yeah if everyone is saying easy then obviously it was easy but if somebody is finding it hard and some I mean obviously there must be some criteria na, in 10th standard that you must attain this much marks then only you can move to 11th standard with science stream in your school Salman Khalid
yeah sir
what is that cutoff
That was too less around.
I think 60%. 60% in English and maths, 60 in science. Yeah, I guess like that.
In 100?
I don't remember. Around 60%. Yeah, around 100%.
Okay. 60. Okay. Achha, what about you, Hamza and Heba? In your school, what is the cutoff?
Sir, I don't know about that.
Achha, pata hi nahi aap logo ko. What about you, Hiba? Do you know that?
No, like even some children got below 50 and they are in science stream.
Oh God, acha, paisa bolta hai.
No, sir, no. There's nothing like that. But they didn't bribe anyone. They just said that even we didn't expect that we were going to be selected for science stream.
Acha. So how is the selection happening then?
I don't know, sir. they gave Google Forms to select the streams.
Yeah. So anyone can choose any stream. They have not restricted, with marks.
No, sir. Not like that.
That's a change. That's a change. So see, the students who have a habit of, if they are hardworking, then they can, they will excel in 11th and 12th standard. If they are hardworking, they will excel. Now, obviously, you must be seeing some students who are intelligent. They are smart. They grasp very easily, but they don't work hard. So they struggle during examination. During class, they don't struggle. They understand everything. But because they are not hardworking, so retention thina utna rehta hai. Our brain, it is not created to hold ideas. Okay. It is only created for the creation of ideas. We create ideas, then we forget it. So that is why those who grasp very easy, they struggle in examination. And those who are not very, whose grasping power is not that much, they don't even understand and they are not even hardworking, then those students, they fail. I don't want to sugarcoat anything because I have seen people fail also. Have you, did anyone fail, Hamza, in your class?
No, sir.
In first, online ho gaya kya tumhara? Hamza?
Like the first term?
Yeah, first term?
Yes, sir, online. It's online.
Oh, online tha, isiliye. What about Khalid and Salman? Online?
Online and only MCQs.
Yeah, online.
Oh, तब तो क्या मजाक हुआ है ये तो एग्जाम क्या
हुआ सर इट इज आवर्स इज गोइंग ऑन
योर्स इज गोइंग ऑन
यस सर वी हैव केमिस्ट्री ऑन संडे
यू हैव केमिस्ट्री ऑन संडे अच्छा इतना इतना लिख लिया आप लोगों ने नेगेटिव मेसोमेरिक इफेक्ट
Yes, sir, done.
Now, right, remarks. How will you identify, okay? First of all, remarks. First point in remarks is that, the identification of plus M and minus M. First of all, we will identify whether something is minus M, okay? Something is minus M or not, okay? So I will give you some steps. How will you identify? You know the key atom? What is the key atom? First of all, define key atom. Key atom is the atom of functional group directly attached to benzene ring. Now, all of you, can you identify the function, any key atom? Yes or no? Arey bhai, boliye. Can you guys identify key atom?
Yes,
if I will give you?
Yes, sir.
So, in the previous example, what is the key atom here? What is the key atom here?
NO2. So, nitrogen.
Not NO2. Key atom, ek atom hoga na?
Oh, sorry.
Nitrogen. What about here?
Nitrogen.
Yeah, nitrogen only. Okay. Nitrogen. Key atom is only. Yeah, functional group directly attached to benzene. Now, what you will see? The step one. Step one. You will ask whether is key atom attached to electronegative element, electronegative atom via double bond, via multiple bond. Okay, via multiple bond. If the key atom is attached to electronegative element via multiple bond, then it will be minus M. Okay, minus M group. Okay. If this is, if your answer is yes, then this will be minus M group. But if your answer is no, then you will go to step two and then you will see whether it is plus M or not. Okay. So first of all, whenever you get something, you will identify whether it is minus M or not. And only then you will move further step two. Okay. Step two. Does key atom have lone pair or negative charge? Then if you get the answer yes, then this will be plus M group. And if you get the answer no, then it will be neither plus M nor minus M. Okay, guys. Fine?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Let me know if you're done, guys, okay?
Done, sir.
All of you are done? All of you are done?
Yes, sir, done.
Okay, so step one, step two is done. Now, you will identify whether something is. Okay. Plus M, minus M, or none. Okay. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So, for example, let me write the two. Okay, NH2. So you have NH2 like this. Now I will write it like this. Okay, dash NH2. Now you will understand that this is the bond and this is the key atom and this bond is now connected towards benzene. Okay. And if you will have NO2 like this, then I will write NO2 like this. Okay, guys, this is what this is. Plus M. This is minus M. Okay, so you just have to identify it like this. I will not show the lone pair. Okay, you have to understand whether there is lone pair or not. Okay. Chemical bonding ho gaya aap logo ka, utna aana chahiye aap logo ko. Lewis dot structure se hi aaya sara kuch.
Sir, I think I missed a part up there.
Sorry?
I think
okay,
I up. Part up. Let me check.
Khairiyat to hai, Salman?
What happened, sir?
Aap bataye kya ho gaya? Kaise bol gaya aap likhna? Itni der se hum yahan pe chode hue the.
No, because I left some space. I'm checking my. Yeah, okay, sir.
Done?
Yeah.
Let me know if you are done, okay, guys. Also, let me know if you're stuck somewhere, okay? Yes, guys, any update? Are you doing?
Sir, in question number 10 and 11, are the charges of for a hydrogen?
Carbon, or whole... carbon.
Okay.
Done, guys. No one has sent me any answer. Let me know at least when you are done.
Sir, done, but not sure if all
the answers are correct. Obviously, you will not be sure. Why will you be sure? Pehli bar kar rahe hain. Okay. So, what about others? Hiba, Khalid, Salman.
Done.
Okay, fine. Now, this is also a test for your IUPAC nomenclature and the functional group, okay? On the functional group, how much do you remember the functional group, okay? So, this is oxygen. So, let me just add now the lone pairs, okay? This is the lone pair here. And that is why this will be our key atom. So, this is the key atom here. Let me write the key atoms first. This is the key atom. This is the key atom. The key atom. Okay. Now, this has electrons like this. That is why this will be what? Key atom. It is connected to benzene ring, and it is not connected to any electronegative element. Okay, so oxygen is not connected to any electronegative element. Okay, so please remember that the key atom, it doesn't matter whether it is electronegative or not, that electronegative element or that key atom should not be connected to any electronegative element via multiple bond. Those two things, okay, it should be connected to electronegative element via multiple bond. Nothing is present such that, so this will be plus M. How many of you are right with regarding this? OH will be plus M. Yes, Hamza, Hiba, Khalid, Salman.
I got that one.
What about Hamza and Hiba?
Sir, I wrote minus M.
Why did you write minus M?
Sir, forgot the lone pair. Sir.
You forgot the lone pair. But still, na, then why minus M? Tell me, na, why minus M? What is the key atom here?
Oxygen.
Is it connected to any electronegative element? Is oxygen connected to any electronegative element?
No, sir. Actually, I considered that with electronegative. I mean, oxygen electronegative.
वही key atom वही से connected है अपने आप से connected है क्या? नहीं ना? So take care of that. Okay, take care of that. It's fine. Now what about this one? COOH. Now please remember that the COOH, the real structure is like this. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so you have to consider this also. Now see, what is the key atom? Carbon is the key atom, yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Now carbon is connected to?
Electronegative.
Via multiple bond. That is why this will be minus M. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Now what about CHO? CHO is like this. C double bond O, and there is a hydrogen here. Now here also you can see electronegative element minus M. Okay, 11 बाद में करेंगे यहाँ पे आ जाते पहले. Now if you write CN properly, then CN will have a triple bond because carbon की valency तो complete होनी चाहिए ना. So three bonds and nitrogen here. Now carbon, which is the key atom, it is connected to electronegative element, which is nitrogen, and hence this will also be minus M. Now this will be obviously what? This will be obviously plus M because there is lone pair here. And R is what? R is a alkyl group. That is why you will write plus M. Now again we have C double bond. Oops. C double bond O and O are like this. Here carbon is connected to electronegative element, that is oxygen, and hence this will be minus M. Now the CH3, what about the CH3? CH3 is neither none. Nor plus M, nor minus M. Neither minus M, nor plus M. None. Now what about CH2? Now I did not write about CH2, but please see. Is right here via double bond or via multiple bond, or if key atom has positive charge. Okay, if key atom has positive charge, then also it will be minus M. Just write that. But I have done this. Okay, ye humne kiya tha, is wajah se humne diya hai. Aisa nahi boliyega ki humne padhaya nahi hai. Theek hai, dikha de rahe hain aapko. Can you see this?
Yes, sir.
So CH2 hai na, and CH2 mein where it is going, the electron are moving towards the substituent, right? Hai na? Yahan pe we were not learning about plus M and minus M, but we have done this example, correct? Hamza, Hiba, yes, yaad aaya, Salman, hai na? Kiya tha hum logon ne. So this will be what? Minus M. And obviously, if the key atom has what? If the key atom has a negative charge, then this will be plus M. This negative charge is on carbon only, okay? चलिए हो गया तो बताइए.
Done, sir.
Okay, now please write with me. Order of minus M effect. Order of minus M effect. That means which of the following will have the most minus M effect? Most minus M effect. Okay. Look, if positive charge, then you will get the different things. Okay. So first of all, you will have CH2 positive. The CH2 positive, it is complete positive charge. That means it can extract and it can pull the electron towards itself very easily. After that, the highest is for NO2. Then you will have CN CN is followed by COOH. Now COOH is followed by COOR. Okay. After COOR, you have after C double bond O, or you have that is ketone, you will have C double bond O H, that is aldehyde. Now, if you're done, next right order of plus M. So in plus M effect, the negative charges will be very easily donating electrons. So CH2 negative. After that, you will have NH negative. Then you will have O negative. After that, NH2 with a lone pair, followed by OH with a lone pair, followed by OR with a lone pair at oxygen atom. Okay. Now, after that comes, if you have a bond like this, NH, it is followed by C double bond O, and that is R group here. Okay. And similarly, you can also have oxygen with C double bond O, and here you will have any R group, alkyl group. We will give an example for these, okay? Don't worry. Let me know if you're done, okay? Please write this down. Let me know if you're done.
Done, sir.
Done, sir.
All of you are done?
Yes, sir.
Salman?
Yes, sir. Done.
Acha. So there is one more group which is very controversial, which is regarding halogens. But before halogens, look at these two comparison. Okay. So we have one molecule like this. Okay, you have one molecule like this, and the another molecule is like this. Tell me about A and B, which is electronegative, which is plus M, which is minus M. Can you see they are very similar, yes or no? Bataiye, which is electron, which is plus M and which is minus M? Wahi rules hai na, wahi rules hai. Dekh ke bataiye. Lone pair dal lijiye yahan pe, hai na? Bataiye dekh ke.
Sir, B is minus M.
B is minus M, okay. What about A? A is minus M plus M.
Sir, plus M.
Plus M, right? Key atom has, this is the key atom here. Key atom has lone pair. And here key atom has electronegative element. That is a minus M, and this will be plus M. But both are what? Both are esters. Now, when you have benzene ring, which is connected, if it is connected to oxygen of ester, then it is plus M. If it is connected to carbon of ester, then it will be minus M. Okay. So please keep this in mind. Keep this in mind. Benzene connected to O of ester. Okay. And here benzene which is connected to C of Easter. Okay. Or a better bracket will be like this, I think. O of Easter and it is C of Easter. Let me know if you're done. Mm-hmm. Are you done, guys?
Yes, sir. Done.
Next point is important, that is mesomeric effect in halogens. Okay. Now see, halogens have halogens, that is fluorine, chlorine, bromine, and iodine. Have lone pair electrons. And hence, they show plus M effect. Okay, plus M effect. But they are also, what? Very electronegative. They are also very electronegative. If they are very electronegative, then what happens? Hence, they show minus I effect. Okay. That means we can say two things regarding halogens. Halogens are electron donating via resonance. And halogens are electron withdrawal group via inductive effect. Okay. So these are the two points. Halogens are electron donating via resonance. Halogens are electron withdrawing via inductive effect. For halogens, the minus I is dominant over plus M. Minus I is dominant over plus M. Hence, halogens, hence the net effect is is that halogens, hence the net effect is that halogens withdraw electron from benzene.
Sir, could you show the first point?
Yeah, sure. Let me just zoom out a bit, okay? Okay, you can see every point now.
Done, sir.
Is everyone done?
Yes, sir, done.
Wait, sir, last one.
Okay.
Yeah, done, sir.
Okay. So again, now we will learn about the application of mesomeric effect. Okay, so again, so mesomeric effect will be used for the comparison of many stability, acidic effect, and basic effects. Okay. So first of all, right, application of mesomeric effect. Okay, application of mesomeric effect. So what is mesomeric effect? They can be applied to, you can get the stability order. Okay, so stability of intermediates. Stability, okay, stability, this is like stability. Second is acidic character, basic character. Okay. Electrophilicity. Nucleophilicity. Electrophilicity and nucleophilicity. So these are the different applications of mesomeric effect. So slowly we will learn, but let us first start with stability. Okay, we will do some questions on stability, then we can move on. Okay, fine. Okay, yes or no? Boliye. Yes or no? Kahan gaye? Haan na, kuch nahi bol rahe.
Sorry sir, what did you ask?
Aage padhe, likh liya?
No sir, no, writing.
So we will just be doing stability today, and slowly, I mean, as the chapter proceeds and as you get to hydrocarbons and on, then we will be using acidic character, basic character, nucleophilicity and electrophilicity.
Done, sir.
What about others? Siba, Khalid, Salman?
Yes, sir, done.
Okay. Suppose you have a benzene ring, and what is happening, you have a CH2 positive here. Okay, now see, benzene ring is what? C6H5. Okay, just if you are attaching it to something, then it is C6H5. Now let us imagine you have this A, then you have B, in this you have two benzene groups which is attached to a carbon, one hydrogen, and there is a positive charge here. And see if you have a benzene ring like this. A positive charge here, okay? So tell me, which will be the most stable? Okay, kaise batayenge? See, what is the benzene ring doing? It is increasing the electron density. Yes or no? Yes or no? Tell me.
Yes, sir.
It is increasing. What is happening in whenever if you have more number of benzene ring, what is benzene ring doing? Okay, so benzene ring is increasing electrons at CH2 positive. Yes or no? इतना सबको दिख रहा है? हाँ या ना बोलिए.
इतना सही पेपर राइट.
व्हाट अबाउट सेकंड वन? सेकंड वन में भी तो नहीं. ए डबल द सेकंड वन आल्सो. सी आई एम डार्क आई मीन सी. देखिए ए डबल बॉन्ड बी सिंगल बॉन्ड सी, सी पे पॉजिटिव चार्ज. ए डबल बॉन्ड बी सी सिंगल बॉन्ड सी, सी पे पॉजिटिव चार्ज. ए डबल बॉन्ड बी सिंगल बॉन्ड ए डबल बॉन्ड बी सिंगल बॉन्ड सी एंड सी हैज अ पॉजिटिव चार्ज. ओके अगेन सी हियर ए डबल बॉन्ड बी सिंगल बॉन्ड सी एंड सी हैज अ पॉजिटिव चार्ज. ए डबल बॉन्ड बी सिंगल बॉन्ड सी एंड सी हैज अ पॉजिटिव चार्ज. हियर आल्सो ए डबल बॉन्ड बी सिंगल बॉन्ड सी एंड सी हैज अ पॉजिटिव चार्ज. सो ऑल दीज आर व्हाट कंडीशंस फॉर रेजोनेंस राइट. एंड ऑल ऑफ देम व्हाट विल हैपन. सी C has a positive charge. That means the electron density will be coming towards carbon. Yes or no? It is a minus M group, na? इतना दिख रहा है कि नहीं आप लोगों को बताइए. It is a minus M group. All of you can see that. Hamza, yes, Salman, Khalid, Hiba.
Yes, sir.
Yes, na? What yes, it sir. Will do? It will pull the electrons. It will pull the electrons. So what is happening? If it is pulling the electrons, then the electron density is increasing at CH2 positive. At C positive, let us just write the carbon positive. Yes or no? The positively charged carbon atom. Bataiye. Now, if the electron density is increasing, then what I can say? The positive charge is decreasing. Yes or no? Yes or no, guys?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Because electron is what? Electron is negatively charged. Electron is negatively charged. And this reaching towards the carbon positive and it is neutralizing it. That means what is happening? The positive charge is decreasing. If the positive charge is decreasing, then tell me, if the charge is lowered, then stability increases or decreases? What happens to stability if the charge is decreasing? Stability increases or decreases? Increases, very good. Jab bhi stability ki baat hai, charge ki baat hai na, then please think, will you ever touch a charge? Tell me. Will you ever touch a charge? A charge?
No,
na? Then you, because you have to be stable. Ab jaise touch kijiyega, aap unstable ho jayega, right? So whenever there is a decrease in charge or charge density, then stability increases. Okay, stability increases. That means, see, here it has only one benzene ring to give electron. Here it has two benzene ring. Here it has three benzene ring. So the order will be A will be the least stable, followed by B and followed by C. This will be the stability order. Why? Because here you have only one benzene ring, which is giving you electrons. So the electron flow is like this. Now here electron flow is from here and here also. Here you have electron flow from everywhere, all the three directions. Okay. So please let me know if you are done.
Sir, could you show the applications again?
Ah, sure.
Thank you, sir.
Done. Khalid, let me know if you're done.
Yes, sir, done.
Okay. You need to just scroll this down. Now you can write this, okay? Are you done, guys?
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank
yes, sir.
Thank you very much. Okay, we will meet on Monday. No, Saturday. Okay.
Sir, can you show this one?
Okay,
like, applications of mesmeric effect. I didn't write it fully.
अरे भाई साहब अभी तो दिखाया था कहाँ रहते हैं आप
सॉरी सर